said it was already.
It looks okay, except that it's
more. Oh, hey, I'm Pete Baker from Duo Security. I'm here with Chris Czub and Mark Loveless, and we are going to do another episode of Duo Labs Presents. This time we're going to talk about whether or not public Wi-Fi is something that you should be afraid of using.
I'm the victim. I come in, I open up a laptop, I'm doing my thing, I'm oblivious to what's going on around me for the most part. Then he comes in behind and he sees, oh, I'm going to go ahead and target somebody on this network. He looks good. So you see that information. So you see, okay, well, they make it this bank. They obviously go to this dating site.
Right.
They're on these social networks.
You could probably pretty quickly figure out who they work for.
You can figure out through their
where they live.
Yeah, like they fire up a VPN and all of a sudden they're talking to work. Yeah. And you know where they work.
And so even that stuff is behavioral, that you know somebody can kind of have a policy around, like, I'm not going to do that on this laptop. But the things you can't really avoid are the lookups to, like you said, HP servers on an HP laptop, or software updates. When you open your Mac, it's going to call back to Apple servers, see if there's an operating system update. That gives you some decent information about which computers are worth going after, or which ones are the easy targets when you're on public Wi-Fi.
Right.
And then from there, like, what does that become useful for? Say I've determined that somebody in this coffee shop has an HP, and now what do I get to do with that?
Well, if you determine that they have, you know, an HP, and you know that there's a bug with the updater, say, and you can see that they're checking for updates, you could inject fake updates or exploit that bug or something.
I think a lot of people kind of take the attitude that, like, I'm not doing anything that's worth targeting me for. And it's not necessarily that you're being targeted. It's a blanket approach to everybody on the Wi-Fi to see what they might be able to get.
If my target was, let's say, credit card information, and let's say that a really nice guy came walking in, he drove up in an extremely expensive car, and you got someone that's, you know, dressed like a hobo like this guy, I would probably go after the guy that had the nice car. Even if I didn't necessarily get anything while he was there, I'd want to put something on there to where I can get back onto his computer anytime I want, like when he gets home.
Right.
Sometimes some of these exploits, they'll be reliable, say, 1 out of 4 times.
Yeah.
And as an attacker, you may only get one shot with that guy that's opening it up to quickly check email. But even then, just the odds of you intersecting with an attacker on a public network are going to be lower. They're going to be greater than when you're at home.
Yeah.
Obviously.
I would say the odds of being sniffed are fairly decent. Even if people are using encrypted websites, a lot of people will click through those cert warnings.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Google Chrome makes it more difficult to do that kind of thing because they have preloaded sites that they won't allow you to do that to by default. WPA2, you know, has encryption you can optionally enable, which makes it moderately more difficult.
So what's the moral of the story here?
Use encryption. Like I said, Let's Encrypt is free. It's out there. You can get SSL certs. It's really easy to use. There's really no excuse anymore.
Mm-hmm.
And then, you know, enable the WPA2 encryption if that's available to you.
Is it a decent rule of thumb that if I see the little lock in my address bar in the browser, that relatively
okay, as long as you don't, it's not a fave icon you're looking at. Yeah.
Right.
I would try to not go shopping online while you're,
yeah,
sitting at a coffee shop, as tempting as it is.
A big thing that we're looking at doing now is like phishing attempts, and like, what can we do to not just deal with the people's devices and their networks, but actually their behavior. And probably one of the more common ways of somebody getting a password is by asking somebody for their password, and they just happen to give it up freely without realizing what they're putting it into. So your password's out there, you know, what are you going to do about it other than hoping that two-factor authentication is an option?
Talking about two-factor, there are different kinds of two-factor. For example, the most common kind, which is called time-based one-time password, where you get, you know, six-digit thing on your phone, that can still be phished.
Okay.
So if the attacker has your password, they have that code, they have a 30-second window where they can log in with that information.
Right.
So it's a little bit different from like Duo Push, which is out of band, where the backend server has to communicate with your phone directly, so that can't be phished as easily.
And your phone may not be on, it may not even be on the Wi-Fi. It's got its own network that it can go over, so they're not even.
And that's encrypted anyway.
Right, and that's all encrypted. And it's not, you wouldn't even see a password. There's no option to enter something you found going over the Wi-Fi.
Yeah.
The things that you should do today.
Don't reuse passwords.
Get better passwords. Update everything on your computer. Maybe just uninstall Flash. Everyone's gonna at some point, so just get rid of Flash. We don't need it anymore. You can still watch YouTube without it. Java, maybe not. Keep it up to date, and definitely keep your operating system up to date. On your phones, on your iPads, on your tablets, on your Androids, on your computers. And then, you know, obviously just kind of be careful about what you're doing when you're on public Wi-Fi. Thanks for watching this again. If you've got anything else that you'd like us to test out and see if it's plausible or true or likely or bullshit, tweet at us at @duo_labs. And we'll have a couple more of these coming out soon. Thanks a lot.